Okay, welcome all the students or all the learners to the online class of Odisha State Open University. Today we are having with us Mr. Rajesh Kumar Karna. He is a assistant professor in Pondicherry Central University, Pondicherry itself. And he will be teaching you or he will deliver his lecture on five unit of your block 4 political social movement and politics in India, MPS 9. So dealing 4 unit in a one class is, I know it's a big challenge. It's challenging for the resource person to cover up all the 4-5 units in a one class in the stipulated time period. So I would request Rajesh Kumar Karna to be specific and be brief to provide a sense of information or sense of argument to the student through which they can acquainted with the idea which is deals in the all the five units. The resource person of ours today is, he will dealing with agrarian movement, working class movement, fishing flock movement, environmental and ecological movement, and social movement and democracy and assessment. So I just want to say the students are less, but don't worry, the session is being recorded. And we will reach in our website through different website for the blog and for the different other purpose. So now I would request you to deliver your lecture. Take 1 hour and 10 to 15 minutes, and then we'll take some question if the students will ask you, or else we can carry forward on the next session. So I would request you to deliver your lecture now.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Antarjami, and myself, Rajesh Kumar Karna. And one more clarification, I'm not working exactly in Central University of Pondicherry, but there are affiliated colleges to it in Pondicherry. So I'm working there as a assistant professor in politics. So I would like to thank this entire Odisha State Open University community to invite me for delivering this very beautiful topic on this very beautiful topic. Though it's a vast area they have allotted me, and to cover it in one class is really, it's a very difficult task. Even it's very difficult to give justice to each and every chapters they have allotted me. So, by the way, I will try to do my best. So there are things which were allotted to me on this paper called Social Movements in India, particularly in specific to Indian context. Agrarian movements, worker class movements, fisher folk communities, fisher folks movements, environmental and ecological movements, and how we can put all these social movements into the larger context of democracy, because that is our central goal: how to strengthen the democratic fabric of the society of the country, and how these movements gonna help us to strengthen that ideology that we are adhering to, we are dealing with that democratic system that we are all a part of, and we are trying to strengthening it by our own actions, by our own different means. So this social movements, this sustained, organized, collective actions intended to bring certain social changes. This is very important. These social movements are continuous process. It's not 1-2 day, we are just fighting for 2 days. No, you need to fight continuously. Then it's not individual actions, it's our collective actions. And what we want to seek, we want to bring certain social changes. That is our goal. Either that may be to change, to replace the existing system in a total, or to bring certain reform, certain changes within the existing system. So that is our goal. So this social movements we can understand in certain ways. And before that, the social movements can be divided on certain parameters, like the actors involved, the issues involved, mode of mobilizations, how they are fighting, माने से माने को को weapon द्वारा माने mobilize कर चुनती, that's important. So generally on issue specific, we used to divide it into general movements and group specific or particularistic movement. General movements used to be those movement which involve people across the group. There are not particular group that involve into it. So across caste, gender, ethnicity, country, people can join and they are fighting for an example, environmental movements, movement for peace, human right movements can be taken into such example that it's a general movement. And apart from that, there are very much particular issue specific or group specific movements. Take an example, LGBT movement, fishermen folks movements, movement against sex selective abortions. So these are targeting to a particular group of people and a particular area. So we can look into that. This is, we can divide. Apart from these divisions, we can also understand these social movements on certain basic component it inherent. Each movement used to have certain components. Take an example, movement for what? हमें जो movement करूँ छूँ तार goal कान, हमें कान आ पैबाल लगी चाहूँ छूँ. What we are seeking? जन social change के हमें अनबाल ले चाहूँ छूँ, से ता कैन social change है, कैन कैन ता हमें अनबाल लगी चाहूँ छूँ. सेटा हूँ छूँ, हमर goal, goal कान है. अब हमें से goal लगी, अजी fight करूँ छूँ, उटे movement रह जाए वाले, जेत वाले हमें join करूँ छूँ, हमें से goals मन को लगी fight करूँ छूँ. যেতবেলা আমি এনভায়রনমেন্টাল মুভমেন্ট রে জয়েন করছু এনভায়রনমেন্টাল র আমার পার্টিকুলার যদি লোকাল মুভমেন্ট এ যদি আমি গোটে ড্যাম কনস্ট্রাকশন হউছি আর ড্যাম রে ইকোলজিক্যাল ডিগ্রে মানে ডিস্ট্রাকশন সবার আছে আমি তাহাকে প্রোটেক্ট করবা লাই যাচ্ছু তো আমার পাখে কতটা গোল রহুছি এই গোল এটা বি ডিফাইন করছে যে কত অ্যাক্টরস ইনভলভ হইছে যদি ন্যাশনাল অ্যাক্টরস ইনভলভ হইছন গ্লোবাল অ্যাক্টর ইনভলভ হইছন আমার গোল ব্রড হই যাবে যদি লোকাল অ্যাক্টরস ইনভলভ হইছন আমার গোল স্পেসিফিক হয়েছিবা তো আমি সবুবেলে যেতেবেলে গোল আমি ডিফাইন করছো গোল রে আমি যেতেবেলে করছো এটা সবুবেলে গোটে সোশ্যাল চেঞ্জ কে ইন্টেন্ড করছো যে আইদার আমি কিছু গোটে চেঞ্জ আনমা কি নয়া কিছু জিনিস আনমা আর দ্যাটস এগেইন ডিপেন্ডস লোকাল ন্যাশনাল আর গ্লোবাল ওকে সাপোজ আমি ফাইট করছি গোটে ক্যাপিটালিস্ট অর্ডার গোটে লার্জার ফার্ম পোস্কো কলিঙ্গনগর রে যেতেবেলে আসছি আমি যেতেবেলে ফাইট করছু আমি খালি পোস্কো রে ফাইট করলে নাই গোটে লার্জার ডেমোক্রেটিক সরি গোটে ক্যাপিটালিস্ট অর্ডার যেটাকে ইম্পোজ করা হচ্ছে গ্লোবাল ইনভেস্টমেন্ট থ্রো এফডিআই থ্রো আমি তার এগেনস্ট রে লড়ুছু তো সেটা ডিফাইন করছি আমি কেতে আসেন তা করো অ্যাক্টর্স বি আসেন তো সেকেন্ড কম্পোনেন্ট হচ্ছে অ্যাক্টর্স ক্যান ক্যান মানে ইনভলভ হয়েছে বোথ সাইড মুভমেন্টস ফর হোম এগেনস্ট হোম দ্য অ্যাক্টর ইনভলভ সো These actors, both sides, are not homogeneous actors. Takor bhitre internal factions rahisan. Jodi ame kohuchu peasant movement, a peasant movement kohuchu je landlords, state, ki can company, gute side re, au farmers gute side re, e farmers jen category ame kohuchu, category ta gute homogeneous category nuye. Takor mankar bhitre internal factions rahisan. Each category ର କେତେଟା ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟ ରହିଛି ଯେଥିଲାଗି ସେ ଗୋଟେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟକେ ଜଏନ୍ କରୁଛି ଆଉ ସେ ଯେନ୍ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମଟା ସେ ଫେସ୍ କରୁଛି ଯାହା ଲାଗି ଆମେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ କରୁଛୁ ସେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ସେ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମକେ ବି ସଭେ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ୱେରେ ପରସିଭ୍ କରୁଛ ଆଉ ତାଙ୍କର ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟ ବି ଅଲଗା ରହିଛି ଯେନ୍ତାକି ଗୋଟେ ରିଚ୍ ଫାର୍ମର ଯାହାର ପାଖେ କି ସରପ୍ଲସ୍ ଲ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡ ଅଛି ସେ ଗୋଟେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ସେ ସପୋଜ୍ ଗୋଟେ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟାଲ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ଆସୁଛି ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ ଲ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡ ଆକ୍ୱାୟାର ହେଉଛି government acquire kuruchi and people are fighting for that. The land farmers who is having surplus land, he may fight, he may join the movements for better compensation. Kintu gute landless labor, ki gute sharecropper, korkola lok, sharecropper, imane jete bile join kuruchan, ki gute ସ୍ମଲ ସ୍ମଲ ହୋଲ୍ଡର୍ସ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଜଏନ୍ କରୁଛେ, ତାକରଟା ବେଟର କମ୍ପେନସେସନ୍ ଲାଗି ନାଇଁ ବି ହେଇପାରେ। ସେମାନେ ବେଟର ସେମାନେ ଟୋଟାଲ ଏକ୍ୱେସନ୍ସ ର ଏଗେନଷ୍ଟ ଅଛନ୍ତି, ବିକଜ ଦେ ଡୋଣ୍ଟ ହାଭ ଏନି ଅଦର ମିନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଲିଭଲିହୁଡ୍, ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ ଦ ସୋଲ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଲିଭଲିହୁଡ୍। ତ ଇଣ୍ଟରନାଲ ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ସନ୍ସ ଅଲୱେଜ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ଏ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ସୋସିଆଲ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ। ଆପାର୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ ଦିସ୍, ଇନ୍ ମେନି ଟାଇମ୍ସ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ କରୁଛୁ, ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଆର୍ ନଟ ଅଲୱେଜ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଏ ପର୍ସନ ଅର୍ ଏ ଗ୍ରୁପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପର୍ସନ, ଇଟ୍ ଅଲୱେଜ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଏ ଆଇଡିଓଲୋଜି, ଏ ପ୍ରୋସେସ। ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଚାଲିଛି ଏଲଜିବିଟି ରାଇଟ୍ସ କେ ନେଇକରି, ଯେତେବେଳେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଚାଲିଛି ସେଲ୍ସ ମାନେ ୱିମେନ୍ସ ମାନଙ୍କର ରାଇଟ୍ସ କେ ନେଇକରି, ତ ଆମେ କେନ୍ ପର୍ସନ୍ସ ର ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଫାଇଟ୍ ନେଇ କରବାର। ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ୟାଟ୍ରିଆର୍କାଲ ସିଷ୍ଟମ, ପ୍ୟାଟ୍ରିଆର୍କାଲ ସୋସିଆଲ ଅର୍ଡର ର ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଫାଇଟ୍ କରୁଛୁ, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ସ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଭିଜିବଲ, ୱି କ୍ୟାନଟ୍ ସ୍ପେସିଫାଏ ନାଇଁ ଦିସ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଥିଙ୍ଗ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ମେଣ୍ଟାଲିଟି, ଇଟ୍ସ ଦ ହୋଲ୍ ପ୍ରୋସେସ। ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲିଷ୍ଟ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆସୁଛି, ମାନେ ଫିସରମେନ୍ ମାନେ ଫାଇଟ୍ କରୁଛନ୍, ଯେତେବେଳେ ସେମାନେ ମେକାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଫିସିଂ, ଯେନ୍ ଆକ୍ୱାକଲଚର ଇନ୍ ଏ ଲାର୍ଜ ସ୍କେଲ ହଉଛେ, ତ ଦେ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଓନ୍ଲି ଫାଇଟିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ଅର୍ ଫାର୍ମ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ପ୍ରମୋଟିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ, ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫାଇଟିଂ ଏ ଲାର୍ଜର କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲିଷ୍ଟ ଅର୍ଡର ଅଲ୍ସୋ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ ହୋଲ୍ ଆଇଡିଓଲୋଜି। ତ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ନଟ୍ ଅଲୱେଜ ୟୁଜ୍ ଟୁ ହ୍ୟାଭ୍ ଏ ଫିକ୍ସ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ ୱି ନିଡ୍ ଟୁ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ। ଦେନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଆକ୍ଟର୍ସ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ବି ଲୋକାଲ, ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ ଅର୍ ଗ୍ଲୋବାଲ, ଡିପେଣ୍ଡିଂ ଓପନ୍ ହାଉ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଗୋଲ୍ସ ଆର୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହାଉ ଆୱାର ନେଟୱର୍କ ଇଜ୍ ୱାର୍କିଂ। ସୋ ଡିପେଣ୍ଡିଂ ଅପନ୍ ଦ ଗୋଲ୍ସ ୱି ୟୁଜ୍ ଟୁ ବିଲ୍ଡ ନେଟୱର୍କସ, ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ ଭେରି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ। ଆଣ୍ଡ ଥାର୍ଡଲି, ହାଉ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫାଇଟିଂ, ହାଉ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଗୋଇଂ, ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ମୋଡ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପ୍ୟାଟର୍ନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ମୋବିଲାଇଜେସନ୍, ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ମିନ୍ସ, ମାଧ୍ୟମ କେନ୍ ମାଧ୍ୟମରେ ସେମାନେ ଫାଇଟ୍ କରୁଛୁ, ଇଜ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଏ ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ମେନୁଭର, ଇଜ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଏ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫାଇଟିଂ ଥ୍ରୁ ରୋଡ୍ସ, ଇଟ୍ସ ଏ ପିସ୍ଫୁଲ ନନ୍ ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ମେଥଡ୍ସ, ସିଭିଲ ଡିସୋବିଡିଏନ୍ସ କରୁଛନ୍, ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ରେ ବସିଛନ୍, ବୟକଟ୍ କରୁଛନ୍, ଅର୍ ସବୁବେଲେ ଆମେ ନେଇ ବି ଦେଖବାର୍କେ ପାଇଁସୁ, ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ଜେମ୍ସ ସ୍କଟ୍ କହୁଛନ୍, ଦେ ଆର୍ ଆର୍ ଏଭ୍ରି ଡେ ଫର୍ମ ଅଫ୍ ରେସିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଅଲ୍ସୋ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଭେରି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ। ସୋ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଆର୍ ଭେରିଅସ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ଥ୍ରୁ ହ୍ୱିଚ୍ ୱି କ୍ୟାନ୍ ପରସିଭ୍ ଏ ସୋସିଆଲ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ, ଇଚ୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଦେ ୟୁଜ୍ ଟୁ ହ୍ୟାଭ୍ ସଡନ୍ ଦେୟର ଗୋଲ୍ସ, ଆକ୍ଟର ଇନଭଲ୍ଭ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଚୁଜ୍ ସଟନ୍ ମେଥଡୋଲୋଜି, ସରି ସମ୍ ସଡନ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ମେଥଡ୍ସ ବାଇ ହ୍ୱିଚ୍ ଦେ ୱିଲ୍ ପରସିଭ୍ ଦେୟର ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ, ଦେ ୱିଲ୍ ଫାଇଟ୍ ଫର୍ ଦେୟର ଗୋଲ୍। ଆପାର୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଥ୍ରୀ କମ୍ପୋନେଣ୍ଟ, ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍, ଲିଡରସିପ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ନେଟୱର୍କ, ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍, ଲିଡରସିପ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ନେଟୱର୍କ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ପ୍ଲେ ଏ ଭେରି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ରୋଲ୍ ଫର୍ ଦ ସକ୍ସେସ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଫେଲିୟର ଅଫ୍ ଏ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ସୋସିଆଲ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଭେରି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ, ବିକଜ ଅଲୱେଜ ହୁ ଆର୍ ଦ ଲିଡର୍ସ, ଲିଡର୍ସ ଆର୍ ହାଭିଂ ହାଉ ମଚ୍ କରେକ୍ସନ୍ସ, ୱେନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଚିପକୋ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ୱି ଆର୍ ଗୋଇଂ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଏନ୍ଭାରମେଣ୍ଟାଲ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ପାର୍ଟ, ୱେନ୍ ୱି ୱିଲ୍ ଗୋ ଚିପକୋ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ହ୍ୟାପନ୍, ଦ ଲିଡର ସୁନ୍ଦରଲାଲ ବହୁଗୁଣା, ହି ଇଜ୍ ହାଭିଂ ଏ ଭେରି ଗୁଡ୍ କନେକ୍ସନ୍ସ ୱିଥ୍ ଅ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଲିଡର, ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ ଅଲୱେଜ ପ୍ଲେ ପାର୍ଟ ହାଉ ୱି ଆର୍ ଡିଲିଂ ୱିଥ୍ ଏ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଅର୍ ଇଟ୍ ସକ୍ସେସ୍, ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ ୱି ନିଡ୍ ଟୁ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ। ଇନଭଲ୍ଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ମିଡ଼ିଆ, ୱେଦର ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମିଡ଼ିଆ ଇଜ୍ ଲୋକାଲ ମିଡ଼ିଆ, ୱେଦର ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମିଡ଼ିଆ ଇଜ୍ ଗ୍ଲୋବାଲ ମିଡ଼ିଆ, ସିଏନ୍ଏନ୍ ଇଜ୍ କଭରିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ, ଇଜ୍ ପିପୁଲ ଇନଭଲ୍ଭିଂ ବିକଜ ଅଫ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ନେଟୱର୍କ, ୟୁ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ହାଭ୍ ସପୋର୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟରନ୍ୟାସନାଲ ଅଦର କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିଜ, ଫରେନ୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିଜ, ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ହାଭ୍ ସପୋର୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ୍, ସପୋଜ୍ ଏ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ହ୍ୟାପିନିଂ ଇନ୍ ଇଷ୍ଟ ଗୋଦାବରୀ ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଆନ୍ଧ୍ରପ୍ରଦେଶ, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଆର୍ ହାଭିଂ ନେଟୱର୍କ, ଦେ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ହାଭ୍ ସପୋର୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ୍ କେରଳା ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ପିପୁଲ, ଦେ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ହାଭ୍ ସପୋର୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ୱେଷ୍ଟ ବେଙ୍ଗଲ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍, ଦେ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ହାଭ୍ ସପୋର୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ସ, ଦେଟ୍ ଆର୍ ନେଟୱର୍କ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହୁ ଆର୍ ଦ ଲିଡର୍ସ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଭେରି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ରୋଲ୍ସ। ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍, ହାଉ କଂକ୍ରିଟ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ଇଜ୍, ଆର୍ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫାଇଟିଂ ଥ୍ରୁ ଏ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ଅର୍ ଇଟ୍ସ ଏ ଟେମ୍ପୋରରି, ଅର୍ ଦ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ପାର୍ଟିଜ୍ ଆର୍ କମିଂ ଅଫ୍, ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫାଇଟିଂ, ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ପ୍ଲେ ଏ ଭେରି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ରୋଲ୍। ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଥ୍ରୁ ହ୍ୱିଚ୍ ୱି କ୍ୟାନ୍ ସି ଏ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ, ୱି କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ଏ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ସୋସିଆଲ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ। And there are certain approaches also where we can seize, particularly when we say class movements, particularly peasant movements, agrarian or workers movement, we can have Marxian way of looking into it, Neo-Marxian way of looking into it. Neo-Marxian or influenced by Antonio Gramsci's ideology, that there are different methodologies to it. And us, time is restrained and we cannot go into all this part that already I think the previous resource persons has already deal with all these things. So let's come to the movements which we are going to deal with. The first one is agrarian movement. And agrarian movements or peasant movement, both are different. The agrarian movement is a larger framework. So this has a history of its own. So agrarian movements particularly associate with agriculture and people involved into it. The question of land, labor, and the social relationship that particular agrarian society is producing. So that it's all about. So this movements is always involving into this agricultural domain of things. So what are the goals? Why agrarian movements used to happen? So agrarian movements, if you look at the ancient, means historical period of time, it's used to happen about control over land. Who is controlling and what mode of controlling is it? Is it exploitative? Is it benevolent? Kind of. So, and land concentration, control over land. So that's always play important role. So we used to have agrarian movements against feudal lords, Jamidar, Gautia, we can say big landlords, money lenders. So these people can involve. So historically, these people used to be. So, but when you come to this post-independence Indian context and currently recent problems, we are having a larger agrarian problems apart from this problem, which is already there. So these larger problems are about proper value of your crop, governmental support, inputs like seeds, insurance, irrigations. In Western Orissa, we used to see constant fight of movements, though it's very local. They are fighting for loss of their crop. So they are fighting for insurance. They're fighting against corporate society, agriculture corporate society that we are having in Orissa. So this can also fight against that whole capitalist development that's happening, that companies are coming off their, this large scale agriculture is going on, mechanization of agriculture by which lands are acquiring, people are disposed of those lands, labor, this particular agriculture, this more mechanized modern form of agriculture is intent to acquire land, but not the labor. So those labors, they are getting off, then more modern form of things are coming up like genetic manufacturing of engineering genetic modification of seeds to control more on agricultural things. Like a few years back, I think 10 years back when I was in Odisha, some NGOs in Sambalpur, they are fighting for BT cotton and BT brinjal. So this is a particularly genetically modified seeds that basically in a longer period of time infertile the land. So you need more pesticides to grow. So these things are involved. So this capitalist more commodification, more profit to the private companies. So these things are also there. So this is our goals. We are fighting against all these things when we are saying agrarian movements. So agrarian movements, who are the actor involved? In one side of the things, it is the landlords, jamidar, money lenders who are controlling the land with the support of the state. In the colonial period of time, they are extracting more rent through different mechanism in order to support or in order to give it back to the colonial masters. So they used to take different kind of methods, like they used to torture, they used to expel people from the land. There is insecurity of tenure always, forced gift, bonded layer. So these are the mechanism by which they used to control these people, the peasantry, the small farmers, or the people who are actually in the working in the ground. So, and they their interest is sometime to serve their emperor, king, or the masters, or the colonial master, or sometime their own personal interest also. On the other sides, we are having the farmers' community. And again, we need to understand is that, as I have told you before, this is not a homogeneous category, and all are not having similar interest or respond to a particular agrarian crisis. So, our sabubale amar agrarian field re jetebale dakma actor involve hochan amar goal, our goal is not always economical. Suppose women are involving into it, Dalits are involving into it, our tribal community are involving into it. So their goal is not only economical, identity is there. Women who are fighting for land acquisitions, the self independence is there, their social space that is going to erode. So these things involve, so we cannot limit everything into that economic economic means economic intention. So there are very much social, cultural interest is also there always. That's why we used to study this in the neo Marxian literature. So, and again, these actors also divided into geographical locations. We used to have different people on different geographical locations, nature of ownership, landholding, size of landholdings, caste, that also matters when these actors are. So in a broader framework into this farmers category, there are different scholars who divided them. So take an example, Utsa Patnaik on her book, Peasant Class Differentiation, a study in method with reference to Haryana, that was published in 1987. She divided this whole category of farmers into two categories. The rural poor, who are the rural poor? Landless labor, mane aswe se tu. Small marginal farmers aswe, sharecroppers aswe, tenants aswe, these people. So who are either having land, which is very less, very small holdings, or people who are not having a formal ownership over a land. So se mane either community land re depend karuchan, ki se land ro एग्रीकल्चर उपरे ताकर लिवलीहुड सस्टेन करछ जेंता हमर लैंडलेस लेबर हला तो से माने एग्रीकल्चरल लैंडलेस लेबर हला से माने से लैंड रे डायरेक्ट ताकर ओनरशिप नाही नो से माने अलग अलग लैंड रे काम करस बट ताकर लिवलीहुड तो टोटली डिपेंड करू छे से माने से लैंड उपरे से सस्टेनेबिलिटी ऑफ से लैंड उपरे आ गुटे साइड रे जदी देखमा हमें डिवाइड करी परमा रूरल रिच मन रूरल रिच के हेवे landlords mane hebe bigger landlords ja pakhe ki larger bigger size of land holding ache then middle peasantry he parbe or absentee farmers hason jan mane ki they are not necessarily directly involving into the production, some are doing, that's no doubt. So they are involving people into agriculture and they are taking the rent out of it, profit out of it. तो आम एमती कर जोड़े ग्रुप रे वी कैन डिवाइड आल्सो तो जदि आम हिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीगरियन मूवमेंट्स देखमा जनरली वी कैन डिवाइड इट इनटू टू कैटेगरीज ऑन हिस्टोरिकल लाइंस ऑन आवर मींस वी कैन लुक इनटू प्री इंडिपेंडेंस मूवमेंट्स प्री इंडिपेंडेंस टाइम रे आमर एग्रीगरियन मूवमेंट्स माने केमती कर थिला आउ पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंट टाइम्स तो देर आर वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ pre-independent movements like Oud peasant movement in Uttar Pradesh, Kheda movement jenta ki Gujarat re hitla, Mopila movements Kerala re, Champaran movement, Gandhi's first movement, we all know that, jenta ki Bihar re hitla, to Bengal province re lot of movements hitla, and more famously Telangana movement that was fought under the leadership of Communist Party of India in the during 1947, I think, if I am not wrong. So these particular movements in the pre-independence period was against the class who are supporters of British colonial master, and they used to exploit peasantry, exploit these farmers in a maximum level. So, can forms of resistance mane use korutile? Both everyday resistance hotula, violent means of resistance hoche, then आमे जदि देखमा सिविल डिसओबिडियंस मूवमेंट जेंता कि आमे चंपारण मूवमेंट्स देखमा खेड़ा मूवमेंट्स देखमा गांधीयन लीडरशिप रे जते बेले होची गांधी कर लीडरशिप रे तो दिस आर सिविल डिसओबिडियंस पीसफुल मूवमेंट तेलंगाना मूवमेंट देखमा जदि तेलंगाना मूवमेंट इज मोर काइंड ऑफ ब्लडी एंड वायलेंट तो जते बेले आमे लीडरशिप के देखु छु से प्री इंडिपेंडेंस मूवमेंट जेहेतु एटा गुटे इंडिपेंडेंट मूवमेंट स्वाधीनता आंदोलन दौर हूँ लीडरशिप पर्टिकुलरली नेशनलिस्ट लीडर माने पर्टिकुलरली थी जी देखमा आम खेड़ा और चंपारण मूवमेंट देखमा गांधी निजे लीडर थे देन राजेन्द्र प्रसाद इनवल्व थे चंपारण मूवमेंट रे गुजरात रे जी देखमा आम सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल इनवल्व अच्छा तो जदि तेलंगाना मूवमेंट देखमा कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी इनवल्व अच्छे तो दिस leaders are not that local peasantry but nationalist leader and there is a larger picture of independence also because they are not seeing this agrarian movement as a fight between peasantry with the landlords but with the British colonial master also so there is a movements against that also to eta mane houtla pre independence period post independence india ra katha jete bela ame kahuchu पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंट पीरियड्स जितेबेले आसछे ड्यू टू नेशनलिस्ट मूवमेंट इनिशियल कांग्रेस गवर्नमेंट से माने केतेटा डेवलपमेंटल मेजर्स नेइथिली माने मोर एग्रेगरियन रिफॉर्म अनबल लागी जेंटा की किछि हद तक किछि प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व कला सपोज एग्जांपल दमे बहुत स्टेट रे लैंड रिफॉर्म होना गला कम्युनिटी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम होना गला पंचायत राज सिस्टम पर जितेबेले एटा आसछि ग्रीन रिवॉल्यूशन आसुछे तो ई केतेटा जन स्टेप गवर्नमेंट ने लिए से लैंड आउ लैंड रिलेशंस जेन अच्छे ताकि मोर गोटे काइंड ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव फॉर्म रे मोर काइंड ऑफ इंक्लूसिव फॉर्म रे नबाले गोटे ट्राए करा गला किंतु सो प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व नहीं है प्रॉब्लम स्टिल परसिस्ट आउ ई एग्जिस्टिंग जेन पुराना प्रॉब्लम थिला तार मान को संगे जेते बेले हमर टाइम जाय बसछे वी आर एनकाउंटरिंग न्यू प्रॉब्लम्स आल्सो तो सेटा भी अच्छे तो जेन पोस्ट इंडियन इंडिपेंडेंस मूवमेंट जिते बेले हो छे एग्रेगरियन मूवमेंट ता ई जिनिस मनकर अगेंस्ट रे माने ई जिनिस ई कॉन्टेक्स्ट रे हमें ताके देखवार के पड़बो तो एटा खाली से पुरोना पीजेंट्री मूवमेंट जेंटा होतला से मूवमेंट्स खाली न्यू है तो जदि हमें पहला तीनटा दशक देखमा फर्स्ट थ्री डेकेड्स एग्रेगरियन मूवमेंट्स देखमा तो दिस पर्टिकुलर दीज आर लेड बाय पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज लाइक कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी गांधीयन then Naxalite movements jete bela hochi or sometimes particular individual lead karuchan ki amar voluntary groups mane bhi lead karuchan leadership pattern douchan au ethu jen actors mane involved thile se mane particularly ame jen kohutla agru rural poor mane mane small landless labor small peasantry au e mane mane marginal small peasantry mane involved rouchan to एटा केन केन जगह रे होजे जदि देखमा हमें वेस्ट बंगाल रे बिहार रे आंध्र प्रदेश रे ई जगह मन को एटा माने होछि किंतु आफ्टर 1980s जेते बेले जाउछे 1980 दशक परे हमें विटनेस करछु नुआ टाइप रो एग्रेगरियन मूवमेंट इंडिया एंड व्हाट इज दैट ना यू नो रिच पीजेंट जेना हमें अग्रु कोतला जे रूरल रिच ताकर इन्वॉल्वमेंट रहउछि पैन इंडियन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस क्रिएट करबर गोटे फार्मर्स पर्टिकुलरली फार्मर्स मन को लेकर पैन इंडियन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस क्रिएट करवार गोटे प्रयास चली छे और पॉलिटिकल दे आर हैविंग अ मोर पॉलिटिकल लॉबी आल्सो एंड नेशनलिस्ट वेरी गुड नेशनल लीडर्स आर इन्वॉल्व इन इट आउ ई जन पीजेंट माने थ्रो पीजेंट माने एग्रेगरियन मूवमेंट्स रे उभरुचन गोटे पीरियड ऑफ टाइम रे से माने नेशनल लीडर भी हेछ तो केन केन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस की लीडर्स मन को डोमिनेंस रहला चरण सिंह गुटे आमे जाइन छु जे चौधरी चरण सिंह इज वन ऑफ द ग्रेट पीजेंट लीडर जे के एग्रेगरियन मूवमेंट्स लीड करूतिले तर पे आमे दखमार के पाइछु भारतीय किसान यूनियन बीकेयू लेड बाय भूपेंद्र सिंह मान महेंद्र सिंह तिकत देन सतकर्णी संगठन आमे देखवाले पाउछु महाराष्ट्र रे सरदार जोशी लीडरशिप रे कर्नाटक राज्य रोहिता संघ प्रोफेसर नाजुदा स्वामी से गोटे प्रोमिनेंट लीडर थिले जे कि मूवमेंट्स करूछन। तो जदि आमे डिफरेंशिएट करमा पहला तीनटा दशक रो एग्रेगोरियन मूवमेंट आउ पर एग्रेगोरियन मूवमेंट्स आमे गोटे देखबा ले पामा वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग्स जे इ एग्रेगोरियन मूवमेंट्स माने से जगह रे होउछे जेन जगह रे कि ग्रीन रिवोल्यूशन सक्सेस हिछ आंध्र प्रदेश पंजाब हरियाणा। तो से जगह रे इमानकर होउछे माने इमाने बेनिफिटेड दिस। आउ सेकंडली कोन है जे डोमिनेंट कास्ट जेन डोमिनेंट कास्ट माने इ एग्रेगोरियन ग्रीन रिवोल्यूशन सक्सेसफुल बेल्ट रे अछन समानकर इन्वॉल्वमेंट रे होउछे रिच फार्मर्स पर्टिकुलरली। तो से माने के हेबे जाट हरियाणा पंजाब बेल्ट जदि देखमा वेस्टर्न यूपी जदि देखमा पटेल वोकालिंगा जदि देखमा आमे कर्नाटक रे यादव मानकर मराठास मानकर। तो डोमिनेंट कास्ट रो इन्वॉल्वमेंट इ प्रेजेंट मूवमेंट्स मके रहउछे। तो से माने जुड़े दशक तक गोटे लार्जर पॉलिटिकल लॉबी तक थिला दे आर प्रीटी स्ट्रॉन्ग आ तक नेटवर्क रहुतला से माने माने पॉलिटिकल नेशनल लीडर्स मान को इन्फ्लुएंस करि करथिन। तो इटा हमें एंता करू हमें वी कैन सी दिस एग्रेगोरियन मूवमेंट्स। बट जदि हमें गोटे ओवरऑल एनालिसिस दमा जे एग्रेगोरियन मूवमेंट्स केनता है इंडियन कॉन्टेक्स्ट रे एग्रेगोरियन मूवमेंट्स आर मोर और लेस रिमेन लोकल लोकली ऑर्गेनाइज्ड मूवमेंट्स ऑन लोकल इश्यूज लेड बाय लोकल लीडर्स एंड फेल टू इमर्ज एज ए पैन इंडियन मूवमेंट्स ड्यू टू इंटरनल एंड इंट्रा क्लास इंटरेस्ट एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स। सो एंती आकर हमें देखि पारबा जे सेमाने निजे ही डिफरेंशिएट रे रहउछन हमें गोटे पैन इंडियन मूवमेंट्स करि नै पारबा। इवन जते बेले न्यू मिलेनियम रे जते बेले 2000 साल पर जते बेले आसछि बहुत सारा लैंड एक्विजिशन होउछि आ से लैंड एक्विजिशंस माने बहुत सारा एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड मन को एक्वायर करूछन नॉन एग्रीकल्चरल पर्पस लागि सेतिर लागि हमें लैक्स ऑफ पीपल डिस्पोज होउछन। किंतु तथापि भी आम गोटे नेशनल मूवमेंट्स गोटे आकार नहीं दे पार्बार जदि भी कतेटा नेशनल मूवमेंट्स होउछे किसी फोरम अच्छा जेन मैंने कि डिफरेंट एग्रेगोरियन युक मानक नहीं करुछन किंतु से गोटे सस्टेनेबल मूवमेंट्स आकार नहीं हो पार्बार किंतु बट वी कैन नॉट डिनाय दैट देयर इज ए ग्रेटर लॉबी आउ फार्मर्स प्लेइंग ए ग्रेटर मान इंटरेस्ट ग्रुप आकर सब काम कर नेशनल पॉलिटिक्स देख। सेकेंड मूवमेंट रहा जिते कौन सेकेंड मूवमेंट हूँ वर्किंग क्लास मूवमेंट। तो वर्किंग क्लास मूवमेंट जनरली तर डेफिनेशन की मीनिंग की देखमा वर्किंग क्लास मूवमेंट बोथ इट्स टेक बोथ ऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर्स अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर जेनटा को फॉर्मल सेक्टर और इनफॉर्मल सेक्टर भी कही पार्बू। तो ये दुईटा को नौछन आकर लेबर वर्कर्स मान वर्किंग कंडीशन एडवांसमेंट लगे सेफ्टी सिक्यूरीटी प्रोटेक्शन कि जदि कहमा हायर लिविंग कंडीशन हायर वेजेस ये जिनिस मानक नहीं फाइट हो बोथ साइड बोथ दुई सेक्टर। तो से फाइट कर मीनस अफ मोबिलाइजेशन क्या क्या रोच जनरल स्ट्राइक हड़ताल नॉन वायलेंट मेथड्स वायलेंस इन सम टाइम्स एटा मैंने रोच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन प्ले कैन मान कर दुईटा मानते ऑर्गेनाइज वे भी ये हूँ जेनटा कि आम कौ ट्रेड यूनियन मूवमेंट्स आउ बहुत जगह डे टू डे रेसिस्टेंस भी आम देखवार लगी पाच। तो जिते बोले वर्कर्स मूवमेंट कहू ट्रेड यूनियन मूवमेंट्स गोटे इंपोर्टेंट रोल से प्ले करसी किंतु ट्रेड यूनियन मूवमेंट आउ वर्कर्स मूवमेंट्स आर नॉट सेम। वर्कर्स मूवमेंट्स आर मोर लार्जर लार्जर वाइडर इट्स इन वाइडर कॉन्टेक्स्ट विच टेक बोथ कैपिटलिस्ट एंड प्री कैपिटलिस्ट मोड्स। आम खाली जो ट्रेड यूनियन मूवमेंट कहे इंडस्ट्री के नहीं रिलेट हो ट्रेड यूनियन मूवमेंट्स टा मोर काइंड ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइज ब्यूरोक्रेटिक आउ हायरार्किकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जेनटा कि थ्रु हेसी किंतु सब मूवमेंट्स टा ट्रेड यूनियन मूवमेंट्स द्वारा ना कि ब्यूरोक्रेटिक स्ट्रक्चर नहीं था दे जस्ट कम अप दे फॉर्म ए सर्टेन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड दे मोबिलाइज विदाउट हैविंग रेगुलर membership or a particular register institution. तो जदि आम हिस्ट्री देखमा इंडियन कंटेक्स्ट रे वर्कर्स मूवमेंट रो हिस्ट्री तो गोटे आम शिफ्ट पाइमा ଗୋଟେ ଅନଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ ଆର୍ଲି କଲୋନିଆଲ ଟାଇମ୍ରୁ ନେଇକରି ଗୋଟେ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚର ପଲିଟିକାଲି ମୋବିଲାଇଜ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ ଇହାଦି ଯଦି ଗୋଟେ ଆମେ ଫ୍ଲୋ ଦେଖମା ଗୋଟେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ ଅନଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ ୱାର୍କର୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ ହେଉଛି ପ୍ରି କଲୋନିଆଲ ଟାଇମ୍ରୁ ଧୀରେ 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 ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ମୋର ପଲିଟିକାଲି ମୋବିଲାଇଜ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚର ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ ଲେଡ୍ ବାଇ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ୍ସ ତ ଯଦି ଆମେ ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକେ ଯିମା ଏଇ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ମାନେ କେବେ ଆସୁଛନ୍ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାରଲି ୱି ଆର୍ ହାଭିଂ ଏଗ୍ରିକଲଚରାଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ତ ଏଇଟା ସେତେବେଳେ ଆସୁଛନ୍ ଯେତେବେଳେ ବ୍ରିଟିଶର୍ସ ଆର୍ ଇନଭଲ୍ଭ ଇନ୍ଟୁ ପ୍ଲାଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ସ ଇନ୍ ଆସାମ ସାଉଥ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆରେ ପ୍ଲାଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ହେଉଛି କଫି ପ୍ଲାଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ଟି ପ୍ଲାଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ଯେତେବେଳେ ହେଉଛି ରେଲୱେ ଏକ୍ସଟେନ୍ସନ୍ ଯେତେବେଳେ କରୁଛି ସେନ ଆମେ ଏଇ ମାନେ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ଇନଭଲ୍ଭ କରୁଛନ୍ କି ପରେ ପରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ 1890s ଆଉ ତାର ପରେ ପରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରିଆଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଦେଖବାରକେ ପାଉଛୁ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାରଲି ଟେକ୍ସଟାଇଲ ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟ୍ରି ମାନେ ଗ୍ରୋ କରୁଛି ବମ୍ବେ କୋଲକାତା ମାଡ୍ରାସ ଆଉ ମାନେ ସେ ଟାଇମ୍ର ବମ୍ବେ ପ୍ରୋଭିନ୍ସର ମେଜର ସିଟିଜ ମାନେ ସୁରତ ଅହମ୍ମଦାବାଦ ନାଗପୁର ଏଇ ଜାଗା ମାନକେ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ମାନେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆସୁଛନ୍ ତ ସେନା ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ହେଉଛନ୍ ଆଉ ସେ ଟାଇମ୍ରେ ଲ୍ୟାକ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପିପୁଲ ଆର୍ ୱାର୍କିଂ ଅନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ସୋ ଦେ ଆର୍ ହାଭିଂ ଏ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ଗୁଡ୍ ନମ୍ବର ଅଫ୍ ପିପୁଲ ହୁ ଆର୍ ଇନଭଲ୍ଭିଂ ତ ଇନିସିଆଲ ଇୟରରେ ଏମାନେ ଫାଇଟ୍ କରୁଥିଲେ ଯେନ୍ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲୋଟେଟିଭ ଅପ୍ରେସିଭ ଏମ୍ପ୍ଲୟର ମାନେ ରହୁଥିଲେ ପ୍ଲାଣ୍ଟେସନ ମ୍ୟାନେଜର ମାନେ ରହୁଥିଲେ କି ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟ୍ରି ଓନର ମାନେ ରହୁଥିଲେ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟ୍ରି ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ରହୁଥିଲା ତାଙ୍କର ଏଗେନଷ୍ଟରେ ବେଟର ୱାର୍କିଂ କଣ୍ଡିସନ ବେଟର ୱେଜେସ ବୋନସ ଆଉ ଏଇ ଜିନିଷ ମାନଙ୍କର ଲାଗି ତ ଏଇଟା ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ରେସିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ରହୁଥିଲା କଲେକ୍ଟିଭ ଆକ୍ସନ୍ସ ମାନେ ରହୁଥିଲା ବୋଥ ମାନେ ବୋଥ ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ମେଥଡ୍ସରେ ନନ୍ ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ସିଭିଲ ଡିସୋବିଡିଏନ୍ସ ମେଥଡ୍ରେ ବି ଥିଲା ଆଉ କେତେଟା ଜାଗାରେ ପେସିଭ ରେସିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଫର୍ମରେ ବି ଏ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ ମାନେ ରହୁଥିଲା ତ ଗ୍ରେଜୁଆଲି କ'ଣ ହେଲା ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ ଯେନ୍ଟା ଆମେ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ କହିଛୁ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ସ ବିକମ୍ ଏ ମେଜର ୱିପେନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ଦିସ୍ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଇନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ତ ଆମେ ଯଦି ଦେଖମା 1910 ପରେ ଫ୍ରିକ୍ୱେଣ୍ଟ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ ଆମେ ଦେଖବାର୍ ଲାଗି ପାଉଛୁ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ଡାଟା କେ ଦେଖବାର୍ ଲାଗି ଯିମା 1921ରେ ଖାଲି ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ୱିଟନେସ 396 ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ସ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇନଭଲ୍ଭ 6 ଲାକ୍ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ 1921 ଟୁ 25ରେ ଯଦି ଦେଖମା ଏଇ 4 ବରଷରେ ଆନୁଆଲି 4 ଲାକ୍ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ଇନଭଲ୍ଭ ରହୁଥିଲେ ଏଇ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ତ ଗୋଟେ ଅନଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ ୱେରେ ନେଇକରି ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ ଗୋଟେ ମୋର ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ ୱେ ଅଫ୍ ମେଥଡୋଲୋଜି ସେମାନେ ବିଲ୍ଡ କରୁଛନ୍ ଆଉ ଧୀରେ ଧୀରେ ସେମାନେ ଜେନେରାଲ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ କେ ତାଙ୍କର ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାରଲି ଆଜ୍ ଏ ୱିପନ୍ ଆକାରେ ନଉଛନ୍ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଦେଖମା ତ ତାର ପରେ ପରେ ବି ଗୋଟେ ସେମାନେ ଅନଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ ସୂତ୍ରରୁ ଗୋଟେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ ୱେରେ ଆସି ବସୁଛନ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ ମାନଙ୍କର ଏମର୍ଜେନ୍ସ ହଉଛି ଜେନେରାଲି ଆଗରୁ ଲୋକାଲ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ ମ୍ୟାନ୍ ଥିଲା ଆଣ୍ଡ ଗ୍ରେଜୁଆଲି ୱି ଆର୍ ୱିଟନେସିଂ ଲାର୍ଜ ପ୍ୟାନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆନ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ୍ସ ତ କେନ୍ କେନ୍ ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟର୍ସ ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲୁଏନ୍ସ କରିଛେ ଏଇ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନିଜମ୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆରେ ଗ୍ରୋ କରବାର୍ ଲାଗି ଯଦି ଆମେ ଦେଖବାର୍ ଲାଗିଛେ ଆମେ ତ ଯେତେ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରିଆଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ସେତେବେଳେ ଯାଉଛେ ତାର ସାଙ୍ଗେ ଗୋଟେ କ୍ଲାସ୍ କନସିୟସନେସ୍ ଗ୍ରୋ କରୁଛେ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ମାନଙ୍କର ଭିତରେ ସେଟା ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ରୋଲ୍ ପ୍ଲେ କରୁଛି ଯଦି ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ତ କ୍ଲାସ୍ କନସିୟସନେସ୍ ଗ୍ରୋ କରୁଛେ ତାଙ୍କର ଭିତରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ 1920ର କଥା କହୁଛୁ 1930ର କଥା କହୁଛୁ ରଷିଆନ ରିଭଲ୍ୟୁସନ୍ସ ବହୁତ ଆକାର ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲୁଏନ୍ସ କରିଥିଲା ରଷିଆନ ରିଭଲ୍ୟୁସନ୍ସ ଇଜ୍ ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲୁଏନ୍ସ ଯେନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଷ୍ଟ ପାର୍ଟି ମାନେ ଆସୁଛନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଷ୍ଟ ଲିଡର ମାନେ ଆସୁଛନ୍ ଇଭେନ୍ ଆୱାର କମ୍ୟୁନିଷ୍ଟ ପାର୍ଟି ୱାଜ୍ ଫର୍ମ ନଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ଫର୍ମ ଇନ୍ ସୋଭିଏତ ୟୁନିଅନ୍ ତ ସେମାନେ ଆସିକରି ଇନ ମୋବିଲାଇଜ କରୁଛନ୍ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ କେ ନେଇକରି ତ ସେଟା ଗୋଟେ ବହୁତ ବଡ଼ ରୋଲ୍ ପ୍ଲେ କରୁଛି ଆଉ ଏଇ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ଟାଇମ୍ ଯଦି ଦେଖମା ତ ଯେନ୍ ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡ ୱାର୍ ଟାଇମ୍ରେ ଯେନ୍ ମୋର ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରିଆଲ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ସନ୍ସ ର ଯେନ୍ ଗୋଟେ ସେଟା ରହୁଥିଲା ସେଟା ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରେଟି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ରୋଲ୍ ପ୍ଲେ କଲା ଯେ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ମାନଙ୍କର ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରତି ଗୋଟେ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରଙ୍ଗ ହେବା ଲାଗି ବିକଜ ୱି ନିଡ୍ ଲାର୍ଜର ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରିଆଲ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ସନ୍ ସୋ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ଆର୍ ଇନ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରେଟି ଆଡଭାଣ୍ଟେଜ ପୋଜିସନ୍ ଟୁ ସିକ୍ ଦେୟାର ଡିମାଣ୍ଡସ୍ ଆଇଦର ଇନ୍ ବେଟର ୱେଜେସ୍ ହଉ କି ବେଟର ବୋନସ୍ ହଉ ବେଟର ଲିଭିଂ କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ହଉ ବେଟର ସେଫ୍ଟି ଇକ୍ୟୁପମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ହଉ କି ଆଉ କିଛି ହଉ ଆଉ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଷ୍ଟ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ବି କାଫି ହଦ ତକ ବହୁତ ଜାଗାରେ ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲୁଏନ୍ସ କରିଛି ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନିଜିମ୍ ହେବାର୍ ଲାଗି ତ ମାଦ୍ରାସ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ୍ ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ଫର୍ମ ହେଇଥିଲା ଏପ୍ରିଲ 1918ରେ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ କନ୍ସିଡର୍ ଆଜ୍ ଦ ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ଫର୍ମ ଅଣ୍ଡର ଦ ଲିଡରସିପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ବିପି ୱାଡିଆ ସୋ ବିପି ୱାଡିଆ ୱାଜ୍ ଦ ପର୍ସନ୍ ହୁ ଫର୍ମ ଦିସ୍ ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ মাদ্রাস ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন। তো এটা ফার্স্ট ইউনিয়ন বি যার কি গোটে রেগুলার মেম্বরশিপ রহলে, যে মানে কি এনুয়াল সাবস্ক্রিপশন দেখে গোটে রেগুলার মানে পার্মানেন্ট মেম্বরশিপ তার রহুতিলা। তো ই মাদ্রাস ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন পরে পরে বাকি জায়গা মানকে বি আমি ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন মানে দেখবার লাগি পাইলা। টেক্সটাইল ইন্ডাস্ট্রি যদি দেখমা, রেলওয়ে মানকর রেলওয়ে রে আসলা, কটন যদি দেখমা, জুট ইন্ডাস্ট্রি দেখমা, ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন মানে ডিফারেন্ট মানে আসবার কি কলা কেন কেন জায়গা, আহমেদাবাদ, বম্বে, পার্টিকুলারলি যে অরবান সেন্টার মানে সেই টাইম যে ছিল ইন মানে এটা আসুছি। তো বাই 1920s দেয়ার ওয়ার 125 ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন উইথ 2.5 লাখ পার্মানেন্ট মেম্বার। 1920s রে আমার পাখে থিলে 125টা ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন। তো কিন্তু ই ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন মানে পার্টিকুলারলি দে আর ভেরি মচ লোকালাইজড, গোটে পার্টিকুলার টাউন কে, গোটে পার্টিকুলার ইন্ডাস্ট্রি কে, গোটে পার্টিকুলার সেক্টর কে নিয়ে থিলা। গোটে প্যান ইন্ডিয়ান ট্রেড ইউনিয়নিজম ইভলভ নাই হইথাই আনটিল 1920 ওয়েন দিস ন্যাশনালিস্ট লিডার পার্টিকুলারলি লালা লাজপত রায়, বাল গঙ্গাধর তিলক, বিপিন চন্দ্র পাল ইমানকর লিডারশিপ রে গোটে প্যান ইন্ডিয়ান ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন ইমর্জ করছি, যেটা কুয়া যাচ্ছে দ অল ইন্ডিয়া ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন কংগ্রেস, দ অল ইন্ডিয়া ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন কংগ্রেস, AITUC। তো লালা লাজপত রায় হচ্ছেন তার ফার্স্ট প্রেসিডেন্ট যদি আমি মোর ডিটেলি দেখমা। আর এটা গোটে অর্গানাইজেশন নে যেটা কি বহুত সারা লোকাল স্টেট বেসড ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন মানক, তো এটা গোটে কমলোবরেশন, এটা গোটে জয়েন্ট গোটে ফোরম। তো কিন্তু পরে পরে যেতে 1930s হচ্ছে ই অল ইন্ডিয়া ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন কংগ্রেস ডিউ টু পার্সোনালিটি কল্ড, আইডিওলজিক্যাল ডিফারেন্সেস, এটা ভাগ ভাগ হয়ে যাচ্ছে। পার্টিকুলারলি তিনটা ফ্র্যাকশন এন বাহুছ, ইন্ডিয়ান ফেডারেশন অফ ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন IFTU, কমিউনিটি ফ্র্যাকশন মানে সেপারেট হয়েকি সে করুছন রেড ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন কংগ্রেস, রেড ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন কংগ্রেস RTUE, UC, দেন কেটা ন্যাশনালিস্ট মানে পরপরে ন্যাশনালিস্ট ফেডারেশন অফ ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন গুটে আসছে, কেতেটা কেতেটা স্মল ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন আর ফ্র্যাকশন মিশি করি। আর এটাকে দেখি করি ডিফারেন্ট পলিটিক্যাল পার্টিস মানে কাঁ কলে সে তাকর নিজর ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন মানে গোটে পার্টিকুলার ব্রাঞ্চ গোটে পার্টিকুলার সেগমেন্ট যেটা কি ট্রেড ওয়ার্কর্স মানুষ নিয়ে লেবর মানুষ নিয়ে ডিল করবা সে মানে ক্রিয়েট করবার লাগে স্টার্ট কলে। তো ইন্ডিয়ান ন্যাশনাল কংগ্রেস যেটা কি ডোমিনেন্ট পার্টি সে টাইমে থিলা, সে তার ট্রেড তার গোটে সেপারেট ফোরম ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন কলা যাই কলা ইন্ডিয়ান ন্যাশনাল ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন কংগ্রেস INTUC 1947। সেন্তা সোশিয়ালিস্ট লিডার মানে যেন থিলে সোশিয়ালিস্ট ফ্যাকশন মানে সেমানে হিন্দু মজদুর সভা, কেতেটা কেতেটা জনসংঘ র যদি এক্সাম্পল নামা আমি, জনসংঘ যেটা কি বিজেপি কারেন্ট বিজেপি র প্রেডিসেসর যেটা কি প্যারেন্ট অর্গানাইজেশন বি কই পারমা আমি, সে ভারতীয় মজদুর সংঘ যেটা কি ইহাদে বিজেপি সঙ্গে এফিলিয়েটেড রয়েছে, সে কলা যেতে আমি পরে পরে যেতে আমি ফ্যাকশন দেখবা লি পেলা কমিউনিস্ট পার্টি রে 1970s কমিউনিস্ট পার্টি মানে ডিভাইড হয়ে যাচ্ছ, সেতবে CPIM তার রখলা সেন্টার অফ ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন ইন্ডিয়ান ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন, CPIML যে পার্টি রহলে তার রহলা ইন্ডিয়ান ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন কাউন্সিল, সরি অল ইন্ডিয়া সেন্টার ফর অল ইন্ডিয়া সেন্ট্রাল কাউন্সিল ফর ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন। তো এটা পার্টি স্পেসিফিক আমি ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন মানে দেখবার লাগি পাওছু, যেটা কি দিস পোস্ট ইন্ডিপেন্ডেন্স এরাস ওয়ার্কার্স মুভমেন্টস মানুষ লিড করুছ। ইভেন রিজিওনাল পার্টিস দে ইউজ টু হ্যাভ দেয়ার ওন ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন, আমি যদি দেখমা AIADMK, DMK, দে আর হ্যাভিং দেয়ার ওন ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন, আমি যদি দেখমা ওড়িশার কন্টেক্সট রে BJD যদি দেখমা, BJD ইজ হ্যাভিং অলসো এ ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন ওয়ার্কার্স অ্যান্ড লেবর ফ্যাকশন লাইক তাকর কুয়া যাচ্ছে বিজু শ্রমিক সমুখ্য। তো এটা মানে অর্গানাইজড ওয়ে আমি মুভমেন্টস মানে দেখবার লাগে পাওছু। আর যদি আমি নোটেবল ট্রেড ইউনিয়ন মুভমেন্ট যদি দেখমা, নোটেবল ওয়ার্কার্স মুভমেন্ট যদি ইন্ডিয়ান কন্টেক্সট দেখমা, তো 1982-83 রে টেক্সটাইল ওয়ার্কার্স ମାନଙ୍କ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ ହେଇଥିଲା ବମ୍ବେରେ, ରେଲୱେ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ମାନେ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ କରିଥିଲେ, ଦେନ୍ ଛତିଶଗଡ଼ରେ ଅଣ୍ଡର ଦ ଲିଡରସିପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଛତିଶଗଡ଼ ମାଇନ୍ସ ଶ୍ରମିକ ସଂଘ 1990s ଗୋଟେ ବଡ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ହେଇଥିଲା, ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ମାଇନ୍ସ ଆଉ ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟ୍ରି ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ନେଇକି ହେଇଥିଲା, ମେଟାଲ ମାଇନ୍ସ ମାଇନ୍ସ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଅଦର ଇ ପିପୁଲ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ନେଇକି ହେଇଥିଲା। ତ ଏଇ କେତେଟା ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିୟନ ନୋଟେବୁଲ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ୟୁନିୟନ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ମାନେ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆନ ସିନେରିଓରେ ଆମେ ଦେଖବାର୍ ଲାଗି ପାମ। ଦେନ୍ ଯଦି ଆମେ ନେକ୍ସଟ କେ ଯିମା, ତ ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ ଭେରି ଗ୍ରୁପ ସ୍ପେସିଫିକ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଆମକୁ ଡିଲ୍ ହଉଛି, ସେଟା ହଉଛି ଫିସର ଫୋକ୍ସ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍, ଫିସର ମ୍ୟାନ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ରହୁଛି। ତ ଆମେ ଯଦି ଇଣ୍ଡିଆନ ଜିଓଗ୍ରାଫିକାଲ ରିଜନ କେ ଦେଖମା, ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ଲାର୍ଜ ସି ବେଲ୍ଟ ଆମର ରହୁଛି, ବହୁତ ସାରା ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଇନଭଲ୍ଭ ରହୁଛନ୍, ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟିଂ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ୱେଷ୍ଟ ବେଙ୍ଗଲ ଟୁ ଗୁଜରାଟ। ଆଉ ଏଇ ଯେନ୍ ସି ବେଲ୍ଟରେ ଆମର ଯେନ୍ କୋଷ୍ଟାଲ ବେଲ୍ଟ ଅଛି, ବହୁତ ସାରା ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ ମାନେ ରହୁଛନ୍। ଯଦି ଆମ ଟୋଟାଲ ପପୁଲେସନ କି ତାଙ୍କର ରହମା, ଆରାଉଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଆର 12 ମିଲିୟନ ପିପୁଲ ଆର ଦେୟାର ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ। ଆଉ ଏଇ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ ଯେନ୍ ତାଙ୍କର ଲିଭଲିହୁଡ୍ କେ ନେଇକରି, ତାଙ୍କର ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟେନ୍ସ କେ ନେଇକରି, ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି କେ ନେଇକରି ଯେନ୍ ଥ୍ରେଟ୍ସ ମାନେ ଡେ ଟୁ ଡେ ଟାଇମ୍ରେ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ସେମାନେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଫେସ୍ କରୁଛନ୍, ତାହାକେ ନେଇକରି ଯେନ୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ମାନେ ସେମାନେ କରୁଛନ୍, ଆମେ ତାହାକୁ କହିପାରମା ଆମେ ଯେ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ ଫୋକ୍ସ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ। ତ କେନ୍ ଜିନିଷ କେ ନେଇକରି ସେମାନେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ କରୁଛନ୍, ମାନେ କାଣା ତାଙ୍କର କାର ଏଗେନଷ୍ଟ, କାଣା ସେ ଚେଞ୍ଜ ଆଣବାର ଲାଗି ଚାହୁଁଛନ୍? ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଲୁକ୍ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ ଦେଟ୍, ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫାଇଟିଂ ଫର ଦ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲୋଇଟିଭ ମନି ଲେଣ୍ଡର୍ସ, ଦ ନନ୍ ଫିସିଂ ଫୋକ୍ସ ହୁ ଆର୍ କମିଂ ଅଫ୍, ଟ୍ରେଡର୍ସ ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ମିଡିଲରେ ରହୁଛନ୍, ଯେନ୍ମାନେ କି ତାଙ୍କର ଫିସ୍ର ଡ୍ୟୁ ପେମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ନାଇଁ ଦେବାର, ଦେନ୍ ନେଚୁରାଲ କ୍ଲାଇମେଟିସ୍ ମାନେ ଆସୁଛି ଫ୍ରିକ୍ୱେଣ୍ଟଲି, ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ତାଙ୍କର ଲିଭଲିହୁଡ୍ ଲାଇଫ୍ ହ୍ୟାବିଟେଣ୍ଟ କେ ଡେଷ୍ଟ୍ରୟ କରୁଛି। ତ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ସାଙ୍ଗେ ତାର ରିହେବିଲିଟେସନ୍ ଲାଗି ସେମାନେ ଫାଇଟ୍ କରୁଛନ୍ କନଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଟଲି। ଯେତେବେଳେ 1990s ଆସୁଛି, ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ମୋର ଲିବରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଗ୍ଲୋବାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଆଡ଼କେ ଯାଉଛୁ, ମେକାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଫିସିଂ, ଟ୍ରଲର ମାନେ ଆସୁଛନ୍, ମୋର ସିପିଂ ବୋଟ୍ସ ମାନେ ଆସୁଛି, ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ମଡର୍ନ ମେକାନାଇଜଡ୍ ଫିସିଂ ମାନେ ଯେନ୍ଟା ମାନେ ହେଇ ବସୁଛି, ତାର ଏଗେନଷ୍ଟ ଫାଇଟ୍। ଦେନ୍ ଆମେ ପରେ ପରେ ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ, ଯେତେବେଳେ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲିଷ୍ଟ ପ୍ରାଇଭେଟ ଫାର୍ମ ମାନଙ୍କର ଇନଭଲ୍ଭମେଣ୍ଟ ରହୁଛି, ଆମେ ବହୁତ ଜାଗାରେ ପାଇବାରକେ ପାଉଛୁ ଗୋଟେ ଲାର୍ଜ ସ୍କେଲ ଏକ୍ୱାକଲଚର, ମଡର୍ନ ଲାର୍ଜ ସ୍କେଲ ଏକ୍ୱାକଲଚର, ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ନଟ ଓନ୍ଲି ଇଜ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମମ୍ ପ୍ରଫିଟ, ବଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ସ ଡେଷ୍ଟ୍ରୋଇଂ ଦ କ୍ଲାଇମେଟ, ଇଟ୍ସ ଡେଷ୍ଟ୍ରୋଇଂ ଦ ଏନ୍ଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ, ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୋ ଆଜ୍ ଦ ପିପୁଲ ଡିପେଣ୍ଡେଣ୍ଟ ଅନ୍ ଦାଟ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ବେଲ୍ଟ। ଯଦି ଆମେ ଏକ୍ସାମ୍ପଲ ନେମା, ମୋର କରେଣ୍ଟ ଲୋକେସନରେ ଇଷ୍ଟ ଗୋଦାବରୀ ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ଟ, ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଲଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପ୍ରନ୍ ଶ୍ରିମ୍ପ ଏକ୍ୱାକଲଚର, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦୋଜ ଶ୍ରିମ୍ପ ଏକ୍ୱାକଲଚର ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଡୁଇଂ ବାଏ ଦ ଟ୍ରେଡିସନାଲ ଫିସରମେନ ଫୋକ୍ସ, ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ କଲ୍ଟିଭେଟିଂ ବାଏ ଦ ସୋ କଲ୍ଡ ଅପର କାଷ୍ଟ, ଯେନ୍ମାନେ କି ଲ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡ ହୋଲ୍ଡର୍ସ। ତ ଦେ ଆର୍ ୟୁଜିଂ ଏକ୍ସଟେନ୍ସିଭ ଫର୍ଟିଲାଇଜର ଆଣ୍ଡ ପେଷ୍ଟିସାଇଡ୍ସ ଟୁ ମେକ୍ ମୋର ପ୍ରଡକ୍ସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅଲ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗସ୍, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଅଲ୍ଟିମେଟଲି ଯେତେବେଳେ ସେ ୱାଟରଟା ଫ୍ଲୋ କରିକି ରିଭରକେ ଯାଉଛି, ରିଭରରୁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ସି ବେଲ୍ଟ କେ ଆସୁଛି, ତ ସେଟା ବହୁତ ଜାଗାରେ କାଣା ହଉଛି, ଯେନ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡିସନାଲ ଯେନ୍ ଭେରିଏଣ୍ଟସ୍ ମାନେ, ଯେତେବେଳେ ମୁଇଁ ଇନ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ ମାନଙ୍କ ସାଙ୍ଗେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଇଣ୍ଟରାକ୍ଟ କରୁଛେ, ସେମାନେ କହୁଛନ୍ ଯେନ୍ଟା ଆମେ 10 ବରଷ ଆଗରୁ ଯେନ୍ ଫିସ୍ ଭେରିଏଣ୍ଟସ୍ ପାଇବାର ଲାଗି ପାଉଥିଲା, ଇହାଦେ ସେଟା ନାଇଁ ମିଲ୍ବା। ସୋ ଇଟ୍ସ କିଲିଂ ଭେରିଏସ୍ ଦ ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଫିସ୍ ଏକ୍ୱା କ୍ରିଏଚର୍ସ ମାନେ ଯେନ୍ ରହୁଛନ୍, ଆମେ ତାଙ୍କର ଉପରେ କାଫି ନେଗେଟିଭଲି ଇମ୍ପାକ୍ଟ ପକାଉଛି। ଏତାର ପରେ ପରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ମଡର୍ନ ମେକାନାଇଜ ଲାର୍ଜ ବୋଟ୍ ସିପିଂ ଏଟା ମାନେ ହଉଛି, ସେମାନେ ଫିସିଂ ହଉଛି, ସେମାନେ କଣ କରୁଛନ୍, ତାଙ୍କର ଓନ୍ଲି ଇଣ୍ଟେନସନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମାଇଜ ଦେୟାର ପ୍ରଫିଟ, ହାଉ ଟୁ କ୍ୟାଚ୍ ମୋର ଫିସେସ୍, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଓନ୍ଲି ଇଣ୍ଟେନସନ୍। ତ ବଟ୍ ଆଜ୍ କମ୍ପେୟାର ଟୁ ଦିସ୍, ଦ ଟ୍ରେଡିସନାଲ ଫିସର ଫୋକ୍ସ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଅଲୱେଜ ଇଣ୍ଟେଣ୍ଡେଡ୍ ଫର ସଷ୍ଟେନେବିଲିଟି, କାହିଁ ହେଲା ଯେ ଦେୟାର ଲିଭଲିହୁଡ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଡିପେଣ୍ଡ ଅପନ୍ ଦେମ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଫିସିଂ, ଦେ ଡୋଣ୍ଟ ହାଭ୍ ଏନି ଅଦର ଅଲ୍ଟରନେଟିଭ। ସୋ ଇଫ୍ ଫିସ୍ ଗୋଟେ ସଷ୍ଟେନେବଲ ଲଙ୍ଗ ଟର୍ମ ୱେରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆଭେଲେବୁଲ ରହିବା, ସେଟା ସେମାନେ ସବୁବେଳେ ତାଙ୍କର ଇଣ୍ଟେନସନ୍ ରହିଛି। ସେଥିର୍ଲାଗି ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାରଲି କେତେ ଜାଗାରେ particularly good season, particularly monsoon season, re, they don't go for fishing because monsoon season is the breeding season. तो जदि मनसून सीजन रे आम जिते बेले फिस मान को कैच कर नौछु तो ताकर कैच संगे ताकर एग्स भी कैच करछु तो गुटे फिस ग्रोइंग के आम स्टॉप करछु वी आर स्टॉपिंग दैट थिंग्स जेंटा की दे यूज्ड टू हैव सो दे यूज्ड टू हैव वेरियस सेलिब्रेशंस बहुत सारा रिचुअल्स ताकर थीसी बहुत सेलिब्रेशंस रहसी ई पर्टिकुलर 2 मास रे तो से 2 मास मनसून सीजन रे जन आसला दे यूज्ड टू स्टे इन देयर हाउस एंड दे यूज्ड टू सेलिब्रेट दे डोंट गो फॉर द फिशिंग सो They are giving a chance to the nature, to the fish, to breed and have larger productions, so they can cage throughout the year and sustain their livelihood. Jenta ki, amar jen modern fishing hoche, setar tar sange kichhi link nahi raha. They keep on catching. So seta, e sabu jen jenis mana rahla, takor livelihood ke nahi kari, takor life ke nahi kari, gote type of threat. Exploitations hochi and this is you know kahwala chaunche this is very much with the active involvement of state apparatus it is not like that the private farms are doing only they are very much in support of the government is in support of them so historically bahut amar jodi dekhma sabu jagare nai west bengal tamil nadu kerala is andhra pradesh e jaga manke fishermen communities mankor यूनियंस माने लोकल लोकल बेस्ड यूनियन माने रहुतला आ ताकर भितरु बहुत फेमस एंड मोस्ट पॉलिटिकली मोबिलाइज्ड वन इज केरला इंडिपेंडेंट फिशर वर्कर्स फेडरेशन जेंटा आ गुटे जेंटा रहुचे आ गुटे फ्रैक्शन जेंटा के परे हिचे 1980s जेते बेले स्प्लिट हि जाउछ ऑल केरल इंडिपेंडेंट फिशर्समैन फेडरेशंस तो केरल रे ई जुडे फेडरेशंस काफी स्ट्रांग वन फिशरमैन कम्युनिटी के लेके और एडवांसमेंट ऑफ fisherman's interest takar rights ke nahi kari takar livelihood ke nahi kari takar sustainability ke lekri mane fight karuchu ame jodi example dama kahla je jete bela ame group specific moments ro katha kahisu we are not always have a lot of movements not because there are no movements there are movements but it is not coming out in the media or it's not mobilized in a larger space larger context so all will know to bahut sara day to day life re resistance chali che day to day life re chot chot localized gute ga jode ga re takar movements mane chali chi jenta ki ame sabu din janbar lagi nai paiba au ye fisherman community bhi sabu jagare jehetu nai no they are so diversely inhabitant that we cannot have a larger national fisherman movement also तो जदि इम्पोर्टेंटली आम देखमा जेन स्टडी मटेरियल प्रोवाइड कराई छे सने जुड़े एग्जांपल दिया हो छे दैट्स इम्पोर्टेंट आल्सो केरला फिशरमैन मूवमेंट तो केरला फिशरमैन मूवमेंट्स का है जे जेते बेले इंडिपेंडेंस हो छे पर्टिकुलरली 1953 रे केरला गवर्नमेंट का करू छे दे आर प्रमोटिंग ए एक्सपोर्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रॉन फिशरीज श्रिंप जेन चिंगुड़ी चास में कहू छु सेटा से प्रमोट करू छु आउ गोटे नेदरलैंड गोटे आई थिंक इंडिया नॉर्वे जॉइंट प्रोजेक्ट आईएनपी ताके को आउचे सेटा इंट्रोड्यूस करा होचे कोस्टल बेल्ट रे अमर केरल रे श्रिम फार्मिंग करबा लागि इन मोर मेकनाइज्ड एंड मॉडर्नाइज्ड वे तो इता जते बेले इंप्लीमेंट करबार द्वारा काना होचे इट्स डायरेक्टली एंड इनडायरेक्टली इट्स पुटिंग ए थ्रेट टू द livelihood and the sustainability of fishermen community of Kerala belt that particular to takor kahla je jete bele I bahut sara mechanized way jete bele large trawler mane chauchan they are catching lot of fish to immediately taku mane fish production mane catching it agar kami jauchi natural resources jen hoche tahake impact pakouchi because me jenta agru kahli they are not bothering about production sustainability of this production of fish they are what they are bothering is maximization of immediate maximization of profit to jan it 2 mas monsoon season re mane bond question seta mane mane kichhi nai kori ke keep on catching fish to seta natural resource ke bhi gote negatively impact kurchi to and a larger sum this is impacting on the livelihood of people the fishermen communities in Kerala to इताकु फाइट करबार लागि पर्टिकुलरली जेन से कैथोलिक चर्च बिशप माने थिले फादर पॉल अक्ले एंड हिज फ्रेंड्स ସେମାନେ କାଁ କରୁଛନ୍, ଗୋଟେ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ କରୁଛନ୍। ସୋ ଦେ ଫର୍ମ ଏନ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ଇ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ପଛେ ଇ ଇ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଯେନ୍ ଯୋଡ଼େ ରହିଲା ଆମର ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଟ୍ରଲିଂ ସେକ୍ଟର ଯେନ୍ ରହୁଛେ, ଟ୍ରଲର ମାନେ ଯେନ୍ ରହୁଛେ, ତାଙ୍କର ଭିତରେ ଫାଇଟ୍ କାଫି ଇଣ୍ଟେନ୍ସିଭ ବି ହେଇଯାଇଥିଲା। ସମ୍ ପିପୁଲ ସମ୍ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ୍ ଗଟ୍ କିଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ବୋଥ୍ ସାଇଡ୍ କଥାଲିଟିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ବୋଥ୍ ସାଇଡ୍ ଇଟ୍ସ ଟୁକ୍ ଏ ଭାଓଲେଣ୍ଟ ଟର୍ନ ଅଲ୍ସୋ। ସୋ ଅନ୍ ଦିସ୍ କଣ୍ଟେକ୍ସ ଦେ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟେଡ୍ ମୋବିଲାଇଜିଂ ଅଣ୍ଡର ଦ ଲିଡରସିପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏନ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ଲାଟିନ୍ କ୍ୟାଥୋଲିକ୍ ଫିସର ଫେଡେରେସନ୍, LCFF, ଲାଟିନ୍ କ୍ୟାଥୋଲିକ୍ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ଫେଡେରେସନ୍। କିନ୍ତୁ ଯେହେତୁ ଏଇଟା ମାନେ କ୍ୟାଥୋଲିକ୍ ଚର୍ଚ୍ଚ ର ଲିଡରସିପ୍ରେ ହେଉଛି, ପରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ମୁସଲିମ ଦୁଇ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିକେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ମାନେ ତାଙ୍କର ଫୋଲ୍ଡରେ ନେଉଛନ୍, ସେମାନେ ତାର ନାଁ କି ଚେଞ୍ଜ କରିକିରି ତାର ନାଁ ଦେଉଛନ୍ କେରଳା ଇଣ୍ଡିପେଣ୍ଡେଣ୍ଟ ଫିସର ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ଫେଡେରେସନ୍। 1980s ରେ ନାଁ ଚେଞ୍ଜ ହେଉଛି। ସୋ ଅଣ୍ଡର ଦିସ୍ ଲିଡରସିପ୍ ଦେ ଆର୍ ରେଗୁଲାରଲି ସବମିଟେଡ୍ ମେମୋରାଣ୍ଡମ୍ ଟୁ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ପାର୍ଟିଜ, ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଆପାରେଟର୍ସ ମାନେ ଯେନ୍ ରହୁଛନ୍, ମିନିଷ୍ଟର୍ସ ରହୁଛନ୍, ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ରହୁଛନ୍, ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ରହୁଛି, ମେମୋରାଣ୍ଡମ୍ ମାନେ ସବମିଟ୍ କଲେ। ଦେ ସିଟ୍ ଅନ୍ ଫାଷ୍ଟିଂରେ ବସିଛନ୍, ଦେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଇକ୍ସ, ପ୍ରୋଟେଷ୍ଟ ମାର୍ଚ୍ଚ। ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ମେକାନିଜମ୍ ଥ୍ରୁ ହ୍ୱିଚ୍ ଦେ କେରି ଫରୱାର୍ଡ ଦେୟାର ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଆର୍ ହାଭିଂ ସଡନ୍ ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ ଲାଇକ୍ ଷ୍ଟପିଂ ଅଫ୍ ଫିସିଂ ଅନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ମନସୁନ୍ ସିଜନ୍, ଦେନ୍ ବ୍ୟାନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଫିସିଂ ଫର୍ ଦ 5 କିଲୋମିଟର ରେଡିୟସ୍ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଦ ଲୋକାଲ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଫିସ୍, ଇଫ୍ ଦ ମେକାନାଇଜ ଟ୍ରେଲର ବିଗ୍ ଫିସିଂ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଦେ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ କ୍ୟାଚ୍ ଫିସ୍ ଦେ ସୁଡ୍ ଗୋ ବିୟଣ୍ଡ 5 କିଲୋମିଟର। ସୋ ଏଇଟା କେତେଟା ତାଙ୍କର ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ ମାନେ ତାଙ୍କର ରହିବାର ଲାଗି ଯାଉଛି, ଯେନ୍ଟାକି ପରେ ପରେ ରେଜଲ୍ଟରେ ହେଲା। କେରଳା ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଗୋଟେ 1981 ଗୋଟେ ଆକ୍ଟ ପାସ୍ କଲେ ଆଜ୍ ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲୁଏନ୍ସ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଦିସ୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ, ଦ କେରଳା ମରିନ୍ ଫିସରିଜ ରେଗୁଲେସନ୍ ଆକ୍ଟ 1981। ଏମାନେ ଏଇ ଯେନ୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ରହୁଛି, ଏମାନେ କାଁ କହୁଛନ୍, ଏମାନେ ଦେ ୟୁଜ୍ ଟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଭିଲେଜ୍ ଲେଭେଲ୍ କ୍ୟାଡର୍ସ, ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ଟ ଲେଭେଲ୍ କ୍ୟାଡର୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗସ୍। ଆଉ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଲାର୍ଜର ଯେତେବେଳେ ଇଭଲ୍ଭ କରୁଛି ଦିସ୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ୍ 1953 ଟୁ ଅପ୍ ଟୁ ନାଓ, ସେମାନେ ଗୋଟେ 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 ଲାର୍ଜର ଗୋଲ୍ସ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ନେଇଯାଉଛନ୍, ସେମାନେ କରି ଯାଉଛନ୍। ଇନିସିଆଲି ଦେ ଆର୍ ଜଷ୍ଟ ଫାଇଟିଂ ଫର୍ ମାନେ ଲିଭଲିହୁଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିସ୍, ଲାଟର ଯେତେବେଳେ ଲେଟର ଆସୁଛି ସେମାନେ ଡିପ୍ ସି ଫିସିଂ କେ ନେଇକିରି ମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ଏଇଟା ରହୁଛି। ମୁମେନ୍ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାରଲି ୱିମେନ୍ ପ୍ଲେ ଏ ଭେରି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ରୋଲ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦିସ୍ କେରଳା ଫିସିଂ ମେନ୍ସ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ। ଆମର ଓଡ଼ିଶାକେ ଯଦି କଣ୍ଟେକ୍ସରେ ଆସମା, ଆମେ ଓଡ଼ିଶାରେ ବି ଗୋଟେ ଏନ୍ତା ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଦେଖବାର୍ ଲାଗି ପାଇଥିଲା, ଆଣ୍ଟି ପ୍ରନ୍ କଲଚର ଏଜିଟେସନ୍ ଇନ୍ ଚିଲିକା ଲେକ୍, ଆମର ଯେନ୍ ଚିଲିକା ହ୍ରଦ ଅଛି ସେନ। ତ ଟାଟା ଗ୍ରୁପ କାଣ କଲା, ଟାଟା ଗ୍ରୁପ କି ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ଦିଆଗଲା ଯେ ସେ ଲାର୍ଜ ନମ୍ବର ଅଫ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରିଆଲ ସ୍କେଲରେ ସିମ୍ପ ଚିଙ୍ଗୁଡ଼ି ଚାଷ କରବାର୍ ଲାଗି ତାହାକେ ଦିଆଗଲା ଚିଲିକାର ସେଲୋ ୱାଟର। ତ ଯେନ୍ଟା କି ନଟ ଓନ୍ଲି ହାବିଟେଣ୍ଟ କେ, ଇକୋଲୋଜିକାଲ ହାବିଟେଣ୍ଟ କେ, ଲିଭଲିହୁଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ କେ, ସେଟା ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟଲି ଥ୍ରେଟ୍ ପହଞ୍ଚଉଛି। ତ ଦିସ୍ ଯେନ୍ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ ମାନେ ରହିଲେ, ସେମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ କରିକିରି, ସେଟା ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ହଉଛି ଚିଲିକା ମତ୍ସ୍ୟଜୀବୀ ମହାସଂଘ। ସେମାନଙ୍କର ସାଙ୍ଗେ ସାଙ୍ଗେ ଦେ ବିଲ୍ଡ ଏ ନେଟୱାର୍କ ଅଫ୍ ପିପଲ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଲେଭେଲ ଟୁ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ ଲେଭେଲ ଟୁ ଗ୍ଲୋବାଲ ଲେଭେଲ। ସୋ ଦେ କମ୍ ଅପ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ଦ କୋଆଲିସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ଫୋରମ, ଏ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ଫୋରମ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ କରାହେଇଛି ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ୍, ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ଯେନ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ୍ସ ମାନେ ଅଛନ୍ ଆନ୍ଧ୍ରପ୍ରଦେଶର, ତାମିଲନାଡୁର, କେରଳର, ଏସବୁକୁ ନେଇକି ଗୋଟେ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ଫୋରମ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ କରାହେଇଛି, ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡ ଫୋରମ୍ ଫର୍ ଫିସ୍ ହାରଭେଷ୍ଟର୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଫିସ୍ ୱାର୍କର୍ସ ସହିତ ଗୋଟେ କ୍ୱାଲିସନ୍ସ ନେଇକିରି ଦେ ଫଟ୍ ଦିସ୍ ହୋଲ୍ ଦେ ଏଜିଟେଡ୍ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଦିସ୍ ଟାଟା ହାଉସ୍ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ଫର୍ ଲାର୍ଜ ସ୍କେଲ୍ ଶ୍ରିମ୍ପ ଏକ୍ୱାକଲଚର ଦେଟ୍ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ସନ୍। ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଟେସଲ୍ ବିଟୱିନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଟୁ ଇଜ୍ ମୁଭ୍ ଟୁୱାର୍ଡ୍ସ ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ସମଟାଇମ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦେର ଆର୍ କଜାଲିଟି ଇନ୍ ବୋଥ୍ ସାଇଡ୍, ସମ୍ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ ପିପୁଲ ଗଟ୍ କିଲ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ଫାଇଟ୍ ବିକମ୍ ସୋ ଇଣ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଫିସରମ୍ୟାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଡେଷ୍ଟ୍ରଏଡ୍ ଲାର୍ଜ ନମ୍ବର ଅଫ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଦିସ୍ ପ୍ରନ୍ ଫାର୍ମ ଇକ୍ୱିପମେଣ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଫିସିଂ ଇଟ୍ ସେଲ୍ଫ। ସୋ ଲକିଲି ଦିସ୍ ହୋଲ୍ Tata's endeavor for large scale prawn fishing was stopped by Orissa High Court's verdict in 1999. So this is two example of fishermen communities movements in India. Then next is environmental and ecological movements. That very interesting, and it's a general movements involving people across the class, caste, creed, and gender. So this, and also before that, we can differentiate also that what are environmental. These two are very important. These two is very important: environmental and ecological movements. If you look into environmental movements, it's a kind of social movements that involve. I'm giving the definition of Tony and Yankee, a social movements that involve a group or coalitions to observe a common interest. There is a common interest. What is that common interest? Environmental protections and formulation of different acts, regulations for the protection of environment, or if there are acts to bring certain change in the orientation of environmental policy and practices. So this is the goal of environmental movements. Guha and Gadgil's example definition, if you give, it's an organized social activities consciously directed towards promotion of sustainable use of natural resources by halting environmental degradation. So the total intention of environmental movement is to promote sustainability, sustainable use of natural resources, whatever natural resources we are having, because our whole existence depend upon the environmental, the whole natural resources, that whole habitat. So these movements are intended to promote sustainable use of natural resources. What's sustainable? That sustainability is that not only we will exploit all the resources, that we will let our for next generations to come and enjoy this beauty of nature, beauty of this whole nature, by halting the current environmental degradations, what we are what is happening today. Ecological movement is different. How ecological? Both are interlinked. Ecological movements also involve the living people, living creatures who are involving into that particular ecological environment and their interactions between them. So when we say ecological movements, it includes not only protection of environment, but also protection of people or indigenous tribes, or even particularly its marginalized community, they used to live on this natural resources. In take an example of river, take an example of forest, and all these things. So it is very much to protect their rights also. It is not only to protect environment, but also to protect the rights of these people who are dependent on that environmental, that particular natural resource. So it's a protection of greater control over the resources, right of indigenous people, preservation of their own culture, identity, protections, and management, management of maintenance of ecological balance. That's very important. Because when we take the example of Niyamgiri movement, that's recently happened in Odisha, it's not only environmental protection movements, but it's a tribal movement also. So when we say that ecological movements, it takes various other factions also, like peace and movements also come into play. Dalit movements also come into play. Women are playing a great role in this environmental movements. Then tribals is very much involved into this environmental protections. So that also, the people living in that particular environmental locations and the relations they are having with that particular environment, that's play a greater role when we say ecological movements. But environmental movement is different because it's only for the protection of environment, but both are very much interlinked. So it's not, we cannot say look these two as a different, but say it's a same thing, same two sides of the same coin, okay, or people involved into it, that we are differentiating to it. Why this when we say ecological movements in your materials, they have given a very good table. So what categories of environmental and ecological movements involve, what are the issues it's taking into considerations, and example of environmental movements happen in Indian context. If you take example, take an example, forest and land based environmental movements. So this movement is against right to access forest resources, non commercial use of natural resources, prevention of land degradation, social justice and human rights protections. So these are the issues which involve into this forest land based environmental movements. Take an example, some example of this environment movement in India, CIPCO movements. We all heard about CIPCO movements. The same replication of CIPCO movements in South India called EPICO movement, tribal movements all over the country. So this is an example of forest and land based environmental movements. Take an example, marine resource and fisheries aquaculture environmental movements. This is the environmental movement which we have discussed recently, the Kerala fishermen's folks movements that come into play. This example of Chilika fishermen's against Tata Group's large scale prawn farming, that also come into that is an example of this marine resource fishery agriculture environmental movements. That's the issues involved is ban of trawling, preventing commercialization, protection of marine lives, implementation of coastal zones regulations. And these are the example. Industrial pollutions, if you take example, the pollution of air, pollution of water, soil, this issue comes. Bhopal gas leak incident recently we had in LG industry in Visakhapatnam, a lot of people died. So that is an example of this environmental pollution, industrial pollution, environmental movements. The another most important movements that category is developmental project. Developmental projects that we adopted after independence, what our national leaders approached, the approach they have adopted, the modernized large scale infrastructure development projects, that's put a enormous threat to our environment. Not only environment, people habitant on those particular area and the locations. So such a certain example, dams and irrigation projects. Narmada Bachao Andolan is a best example of this category. Movements against Hirakud, that Hirakud, it was also an example of Tehri dam movements. It was also an example of this large scale dam and irrigation projects. Apart from that, there are a lot of other mines, power projects, industrial plants, airports, military base. If you take an example, Odisha is having a very good example of this mining environmental protections movements. BALCO project, which we had against anti-bauxite mines. Then military base, Baliapolo movements, that's an example of movements against the developmental plan of military-based development and all these things. So apart from this, tourism also, ecotourism, which we are promoting, wildlife sanctuaries, national parks. So these are also is in one way, in the name of environmental protection, is disposing lakhs of people who are dependent upon that particular natural habitats, like the non-timbers goods gatherer people, mane tribal lok, tribal mane jan mane ki mane kendu patra ki au kichi jinsa jan mane ki non-timbers jan mane eta koruchan, to setaka mankor life upre, takar livelihood upre eta kafi threat rahuchi. That's again in the name of protection of environment also. I can give you a very good example also how environmental protection works. So I was a student of University of Hyderabad, and they started doing this. They started putting a lot of they planted a lot of trees in the roadside of our university. So they again thought that okay, the buffalo and cows will come and eat those plants. So what they did, they cut big branches of the full grown trees to fence this small newly planted trees. So this is how it's work. So those people who are living on those environmental those forest and they are having a sustainable relationship with that, a kind of organic relationship with that, we are, in the name of environmental protection, we are disposing them also. So that's also very much important. So there are certain example of environmental movements. CIPCO movement we all heard about. CIPCO means mane javudi dhariba to mane 1973 re jetebele Uttarakhand re CIPCO movement hoche Sundarlal Bahuguna ankar leadership re dasuli gram swaraj sangh JKR era nouchi Chamboli districts re. So the context was they allotted this whole forest to a private company for timber, Simon Corporation. So say they started cutting this tree. So what these women, people who are living in that villages, they started grabbing these trees. Okay, CIPCO. So that stopped this cutting of these all trees. Okay, so and that leadership also play a very good role. The success of
Hello,
CIPCO
Mr.
movement
Rajesh.
Was very much
Mr. Rajesh.
Dependent.
One second, just can you take another 10 minutes to 15 minutes to wrap up or to end up?
Yeah.
Take another.
No. I will wind up
this
in
the
10
right
minutes.
Time or like you need more time.
No. I'm saying that I'm in the last part only.
All right.
So
then
I will
carry on. Please.
I'll wind up in the 10 minutes.
All right. Great.
Okay.
Great. Carry on, please. Carry
yeah. On. Okay. Then we had an EPICO movement, which is the replication of this CIPCO movements in South India, particularly in the Western Ghat areas. There also in Karnataka regions, people started grabbing these trees in order to protect that. And one is very famous one, Narmada Bachao Andolan. Narmada Bachao Andolan was a paradigm shift movement, because it's not only influenced the national leaders, national consciousness of people towards environmental protections and this benefits of this large scale dams, but also in a global. So this project they have this Gujarat government was planning to made a large dam on the Narmada Valley, Narmada River, Sardar Sarovar project first one, and another one is Narmada Sagar projects. So it's not only destroying a vast range of natural habitats, but also disposing lakhs of people in the name of irrigations, in the name of electric generations and all these things. And World Bank was this was funded, this whole movement was funded by World Bank. So under the leadership of Medha Patkar, social activist Medha Patkar, on the broader framework called Narmada Bachao Andolan, save the Narmada. Under this movements, they fought for fought for the rehabilitation of people who were disposed of, and later on they started challenging the whole goal of whole project, the whole basis of project and its claim for development. The questions came here: development for whom? Is that dam is going to benefit the people who are going to displace off? So they challenged the whole goal of that whole movement. Later, this movement was so intensified and global impact as that World Bank stepped down from sponsoring that movement, and it sent a lot of teams, lot of commissions to look into this rehabilitation and resettlement aspect of this large-scale developmental projects. So this is an example of environmental ecological movements. And we are, every day we are seeing a lot of urban-based environmental movements also. Recently we had in Mumbai, Mumbai people, the city dwellers, they started stopping this railways to cut trees. We had in other places also, Delhi, there was a movement for air pollutions, CNG and other things came up. So these are example of environmental and ecological movements. So while coming into my last one, and which is basically a summary and basically the conclusion of all these movements, is how we are looking into all these social movements in the larger context of democracy. Because democracy is all about people. Democracy is all about people. And we had a lot of institutions, formal institutions like parliament, assembly. We are constantly giving votes. Leaders are coming up. They are making policies for us. There is a rule of law. We all are equal before law. Equality of law, equality of, we are having a lot of rights, fundamental rights, and human rights protected by international conventions and treaties. Then there is a checks and balances. If suppose one institution is doing any kind of corruptions, there is a checks and balances system. And people are having different kind of mechanism and means to control this democratic institutions. So when we are formally having all these institutions, how we can situate, contextualize the social movements? People like William Kornhauser, Robert Nesbitt, Edward Sills, they criticize the social movements by saying that these are anti-democratic. The social movements are anti-democratic because it's promoting populist politics, targeted populist vote bank politics. But is it the reality? Definitely, we are having all formal institutions. We are having right. We are having rights protection protected by our Supreme Courts. All are equal before law. We are having our democratic institutions. We are constantly voting for people. We are the right to make and unmake the governments who are making policy, who are ruling us. But in reality, it's not like that. Everybody is not having the same amount of, they are not able to exercise the same amount of rights. The rights of a rich people, the urban dweller, is very much different from the rights exercised by a tribal people. And apart from that, we are still having a lot of poverty, gender discriminations, constant enclosure of human rights of marginalized community by powerful actors, powerful people, powerful state apparatus. So these all environmental movements, in a larger framework, we can see it's against the state. It's people versus state. So the question here is the interest of state and interest of people is same, or both are same? So that's very much important. Then again, we are witnessing criminalization of politics, involvement of money and muscle powers, corruptions, the ideological orientation of political elites towards development. These all dams, these all are meant for development. But are they there? These are meant for poverty reductions. They are meant for emancipation, progress, but are in reality, these are making further dispositions, further creating new poverties, violation of environment, human rights. And lastly, we are witnessing social changes. Radical changes is taking place in society, which are against the dominant existing ideologies. Take an example of gay rights, LGBT rights. So gay rights was against the dominant ideology of our patriarchal or our this whole fabric. It's an attack on that. So we never imagine, the people never imagine that, okay, we'll have LGBT movements. And though we are witnessing exploitation of them day to day life, but we never care about them. So this new social changes with the changes of circumstances is coming up. So in this context, in this problem, what we are having, social movements are strengthening democracy. There are different ways we can say it. Social movements represent people's growing political consciousness. This encourages greater participation of people on everyday life of political discussions, debates, not only votings. Social mobilizations is also expanding. Social movements and the mobilizations taking place is also expanding political horizon and leading to more democratization of society. These collective actions through mass movements also representing new aspirations, new needs, demand of people, and making our political elites accountable. And these are bringing also new changes in the law, in the constitutions, by incorporating new emerging demands, new emerging issues, and by changing the old ones. So while concluding my things, I can say that social movements is another way, just like we are used to have votings, we used to have a pressure group politics, it's another way to make democratic fabric of the society more inclusive, strong, and sustainable. Thank you. Thank you, Antarjami, Dr. Antarjami, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Rajesh Kumar.
Yeah.
Kornal.
Hello? Hello?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, it's coming. Yeah, tell me.
All right. So thank you, Rajesh Kumar Kornal, for your kind presence, I would say, and your beautiful lecture on the social movement and how social movements strengthen the concept of democracy as such, because the social movement is a process through which we can mobilize the whole population or the whole mass to fight against for their own right, for their own freedom, for their own sustainable process of their livelihood. So on this note, you also conclude beautifully how social movement and democracy is so relevant in the contemporary time in the Indian political system or in the different political system of different country. So I would like to thank you so much. Now there are one or two questions. I would let me read that and please check.
Please.
There is one actually question. The question is like related with the today's lecture, and there are one more question, but it is not that related. So basically, one question is asking about how do you define the historical perspectives of agrarian culture? How do you see the historical perspectives of agrarian movement or agrarian movement in India? Do you get the point?
Yeah.
This is only a question. You can answer that, then we'll come to the concluding part.
Okay, is there any, you're saying another one is there,
but
this one
not,
only, no?
This is the,
okay,
the
yeah.
second
okay,
one is
okay,
not
okay,
that much related, so I don't want to take that.
Okay,
so.
Got it. Yeah.
Okay.
Due to this time constraint, I would start from the pre-colonial, means British colonial history. When we will situate agrarian movements in historical context of India, it's having a long movement. It's not today. It's a constant process that's coming up through ages. People are fighting in their day-to-day life. So it's all about, the central goal is same, the control over land and labor. So that is the central part of conflict. So when you say we can have from ancient period of time, from ancient to modern, though there are new processes are coming off, new actors are involving, but it's not a today's context. So it's not historically when we say, well, historically when we are putting, take an example of in ancient, in early capitalist mode of productions, we don't have this large scale agriculture which is coming up. Non-food agriculture is coming up. This whole they are particularly is a fight between the small peasantry, the landless, that we can say is that rural poor against the rural rich. Rural rich, you can say, they are very much in support of their king, feudal lords, their emperors. So they are exploiting, and there is very much personal interest also. Chowmano Athogunto is in very much example of that. That Jamidar is working on behalf of British and his own personal interest. So this fight, historically, we can put into this, that this is a constant fight, and there is no certain mechanism of fighting. It's happening in everyday basis when it's affecting a lot of peoples. It's coming on in the organized movements also. Everyday resistance is also there. So we can look into this in this way. If I'm not, I don't. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Rajesh Panna, sir. Now we have with us Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra. I would like to request him if he has any observation or any comment. Like, he can take 1 minute
and
give his observation.
Yeah.
So I would request Himanshu Sekhar Mishra. Are you there? If you yes, now you can give your comment or observation, sir.
Thank you, Antarjami. It's on my request only you arranged a class for Rajesh. He's just my younger brother and he's a fantastic guy, right? So I think whatever he said, he touched upon the practical aspect. But so far as theory is concerned, then I think at the last ending or conclusion, we say that, but it is not happening. It's not happening the way it should happen, right?
Yeah,
so why it is not happening? Why it is not happening? For that, what needs to be changed? Theory needs to be changed, or there is something, some problem in the theorization, or practice needs to be, you know, rethought or rethinking of practice is required, right? So it's actually we don't know what we should do, right? So far as my you know, interrogation with various teachers, especially Professor Patnaik is concerned, he always says that the theory must follow the practice, right? So you cannot ask
same
practice to follow the theory.
Mm.
But problem is that once you don't follow the theory, and then what is your reference point? So when you are practicing something, what is your reference point? That is it a practical necessity? Then what is that moral limitation to that practical necessity? Otherwise, at the end of the day, we will speak something, but at the same time, we will conclude that unfortunately, it doesn't happen in that way. So somewhere, I think it is the limitation of social science. And we need to rethink about this limitation of social science, right? So I'm not blaming Rajesh or anybody, but the problem is that the same reason for which social science is beautiful, it is the same reason for which social science is boring also, right? It's the same reason only. But then, you know, some may ask that arts mein kya rakha hai, right? What is there in the social science? My understanding is that, you know, it is the social science that makes your mind critical. It is the social science that actually works as a brake to your development mindset, right?
Yeah.
It's just a speed breaker, right? So it is the social concern, you know, that puts a brake to your development, and you can see the consequences of the lockdown period. Right. So especially social science has this relevance, and we should not downgrade social science. And overall, I think Rajesh is good, fantastic, and there is also a limitation I was talking with.
That's a major part.
That
to touch all
within,
these things is very difficult.
Within one class, then five units, it's very, really very difficult. but there is a structural
then it is,
limitation also.
yes. So it is from my side, I would say my apology to allow you 5 units in one class, and I will try to limit that unit, and I will try to give as much as time to speak to our students. So Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra rightly said about how politics, how the practical and how theoretical is like we have, there is a gap, or you can, there is a problem in the execution in the society level or in the state level. So thank you, Himanshu Sekhar Mishra, for your kind words, for your kind observations for today's lectures. So now I would like to thank Rajesh Karna, Rajesh Kumar Karna, on behalf of Odisha State Open University, for your time and for your beautiful lecture, because basically it's a clear idea or clear vision to the students. They can easily understand what you are saying, or what the idea or what the ideology you are saying to. So I would really thankful for your time and for your patience with us to delivering your lecture, and also like 5 minutes is not a big thing to cover in a one class. So in further, I will try to limit that unit, and I will try to give as much time to give a deep background or deep argument of the any particular topic. So I would like to thank also Himanshu Sekhar Mishra for your time and for his suggestion to ask you or to give you opportunity to in this platform. So I would like to thank both of you for associating with the Odisha State Open University in different capacity, in different level. Thank you so much, sir, and thank you, Rajesh Kumar Karna, sir. And I would also like to thank our technical person, Devashish Barik, for his kind support and for his kind technical assistance to our resource person, to me and to students as well. So I would request Devashish Barik to send the video recording link to Rajesh Karna, sir, through he can like observe what he can like. Recheck what he is saying, or he can develop, or he can improve his lecture. So thank you all, and thank you all the students for your kind support. This was the last class today. So if any class you are not able to understand, then you can just mail me in my mailbox. I will arrange another class for you maybe. So thank you all. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Rajan. Thank you.
Himanshu sir, any words?
Thank you. It's good. It is the last class, right?
Yes. Today is the last class.
It's the last class. But let me speak the person who is going to send that recording to Rajesh. That
okay.
Rajesh must send the mail ID that is attached to the Google Drive, right?
Okay.
So they will send
through
Google
Drive.
Yeah.
It is there.
You
same only.
Right.
Okay.
So that's
thank
good.
You
thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank
yeah.
You.
Thank you,
Rajesh.
Bhai. Thank you all students for having patience listening. Thank you, Odisha State Open University people. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.